like the video and subscribe right now, or this will be in your room tonight. What's the best example of the placebo effect that you've seen? In high school chemistry, we were talking about pure alcohol. The teacher produced a beaker containing a clear liquid and put a drop on everyone's finger so we could taste it. About 10 minutes later, a bunch of girls started acting like they were drunk. They were jiggly, swaying on their stools, and generally acting like how a drunk 14-year-old would. As the lesson continued, they got worse and worse. Near the end of the lesson, the teacher explained that the liquid was in fact water and that no one was actually drunk. Then he taught us the point of that day's lesson: placebo effects. In Space Jam, the Looney Tunes gang is getting demolished by halftime. With all hope lost, Bugs Bunny had the idea to give a team a boost with a drink of Michael Jordan's secret stash. Once replenished, the gang comes back with an epic comeback. The secret drink in question? Tap water. Edit: I know I should have worded this better. Dude, it's Michael's secret stuff. His secret stash probably wouldn't have had the desired effect. Nothing but ordinary water laced with a few spoonfuls of LSD. On the rare occasions when I take an Advil and my headache is gone within 3 minutes. I know that's not possible, but it's gone and that's all I give a duck about. Is it because you take Advil with a glass of water? You're probably just dehydrated. Have you tried just swallowing? Not necessarily a placebo effect, but I had a buddy in college who loved to make it clear how much he loved Coors Light. And oh boy, don't even try to give him a Bud Light, because they taste so different. We went out to a bar with a bunch of people one evening, and upon entering he went to the restroom and asked if I'd order him a Coors Light pint. I ordered him a Bud Light, and we all watched as he came back from the restroom and grabbed the beer and took a chug. Ah, good old Coors Light. My friend and I tried something similar on our friend. He drank Jim Beam and Cokes. Would not even look at Jack Daniels and Coke. He goes to bathroom, and we order him a Jack and Coke. He comes back and takes a drink. He actually tasted the difference and called us on it. I work sound engineer. Sometimes musicians think they can mix better and know everything. In such cases, I select an empty channel and let them do what they can. It has yet to happen that someone wasn't happy with the results, because it always sounds better afterwards. Even the musicians on stage say yeah, it's getting better when asking them while the musician is fiddling with the console. It's like asking children if they see Santa at night flying in the sky, they will see him. A couple friends and I were smoking what we thought was weed, but was some kind of herb sold at the grocery store. This was the first time many of us smoked. All my friends, including myself, acted like we were extremely baked. One person even took off his clothes and streaked down the road. I was texting people ridiculous things for no reason. My friend who got the bud was hitting the blunt saying how good it smelled. Later someone told us it was fake. This was freshman year of high school, BTW. Lol, there was a post on Natal Waithright of a bartender that made a girl some fruity drink, but it smelled off. I don't remember if it was him or the girl that said that. She drank it anyway and got all tipsy. Eventually the bartender realized it smelled off because he forgot the alcohol. Harry doesn't even put the liquid luck in Ron's pumpkin juice. Snake fills bumbill whore. I'm the asshole of my family. Not asshole as in met any doubt your bag, but asshole as in lowest in rank that gets shit on. I'm loved, but not respected. It's just the family dynamic, and there's nothing to be done about it. If I want something of mine to be taken seriously or considered at all, I'll lie and say it's from something or someone else. I bake cookies. I say they're from the Dutch bakery and everyone raves about how they taste just like grandma's. I say I made them from grandma's recipe. They maybe take a tentative bite and make a face telling me, "They're okay." But you know you're not great with recipes, right? You have to follow the directions, dear. Hawk hawk. If I have an original idea, I have to frame it under the guise of something I read somewhere else. If not, it's immediately dismissed, sometimes accompanied with an eye roll. I recently orchestrated an elaborate ploy to repair my brother's vinyl siding in order to save his homeowner's insurance. My parents were footing the bill, so my brother wasn't exactly motivated to shop around. With the help of some friends in the business, I was able to cut his quote from $9,000 to under $2,000. This was rejected due to my not knowing how this works. So, I just made it happen without telling them. The folks they ended up hiring happened to be farmed out by one of my aforementioned friends. When they got the drastically lower bill, I got a phone call for purposes of enlightening me as to how it's done. It's infuriating, sure. But after a lifetime of trying to improve my station, merit chasing, open discussion, emotional pleas, therapy, I've chilled on the pursuit of obtaining the respect of my family. Now I just let them think what they need to think in order for my efforts to be appreciated. Even if I don't get the credit. Besides, my low rank has its benefits. I can decide to no-show a nephew's stupid 22-month birthday celebration with little more than, she probably got lost lol. Yeah, I got lost. You know me, I'm just such a dithead when it comes to following directions. This turned into a long-winded vent. Felt pretty good, but maybe too off-topic for this forum. I'm gonna just hit the post button and let it ride though. If it gets trashed, no hard feelings. TLDR, if a subject's only aversion is to the source, lie about the source. People eating gluten-free despite the fact that they don't have celiac disease or something similar. Yeah, you're probably going to feel better when you're eating more protein and veggies as opposed to top ramen and tortilla chips. That doesn't mean cutting out gluten got rid of your occasional headaches. But whatever. My mill swears by healthy gluten-free pasta, which she serves with that good whole grain bread. I really think she does not know what gluten is. That sugar makes people hyper. My mill sincerely believes it does. I once, as an experiment, gave my then 3-year-old niece some candy and a little soda without telling anyone. While we were having a family gathering, nobody noticed any difference. A couple of weeks later I gave my niece nothing but told everyone I gave her some candy and soda. Even though she wasn't behaving any differently than she usually does, everyone kept commenting on how hyper she was being. Overly drunk friend broke his wrist by falling like an idiot. He then started whining and pissing everyone off. So I gave him a paracetamol which was actually some salt in a water glass. Not only he didn't notice because of how drunk he was, it also instantly made his wrist became painless. So you basically told him the fancy name for Tylenol, and he probably thought it was some Schedule 3 painkiller. That's funny stuff. A band-aid to a little kid. To be fair, it does provide some level of actual comfort, being that the wound isn't exposed to open air and all. And a kiss from mum. Works on adults too. A surgeon recorded his arthroscopic knee surgery procedure. Then put the patient through the same procedure as he would normally, although he just made the initial incision and played the recording. The patients woke up thinking they had the actual surgery and were pain-free. I'm not a lawyer, but it seems this some sort of malpractice and or fraud. At a party, this chick with very little drug experience wanted to try acid. The dude who had the acid gave her a snip of a phone book page, while he gave another dude a real tab. Real tab dude tripped a little bit, saw auras and stuff. Chick with placebo ended up crying in the fetal position under a table. She had no mental issues or anything that we were aware of. She just believed. Dude, your imagination is the most powerful drug you can experience. Remember when SpongeBob and Patrick entered another universe inside of a cardboard box? Yep, not even acid can take you there. I told my, so I paid $9 for a bottle of wine. I was surprised when she claimed to be enjoying it. I eventually found out that she heard $90. Do you enjoy the placebo threads? The belief that new leaders magically, suddenly cause all the things their predecessors caused. Nah, Obama is the reason for all of life's problems. Tryptophan in Turkey. There's nowhere near enough of it in Turkey to make you sleepy. The sleepiness comes from overeating and being tired with dealing with your family's shit on Thanksgiving. As well as a placebo effect, because everyone expects to get sleepy. I told my 6-year-old sister that water with a little bit of sugar is a magical potion that stops tears. Anytime she starts crying, I fix it up for her. She doesn't realize it's sugar, and she immediately stops crying. I know crying is a natural thing, but she cries all the time over the smallest things. Hey, it works. Tell her to man up, and then punch her in the face. Introduce children to extreme pain, so they won't cry over small stuff anymore. So, There was the time I sold someone vitamins instead of ecstasy. A friend of mine likes drugs and he asked if I could sell him some Molly. I was really skeptical about this and never really wanted to, but I jokingly said yes. Now the kicker here is that I had half a pill which he knew about and wanted to buy. So instead of giving him the actual thing, I gave him a glucosamine tablet, a multivitamin which basically is for your joints. Anyway, 5 pounds later, and he now has the pill. Fast forward a bit later to Halloween and they tell me he's taken the multivitamin and is telling them he's starting to feel pretty warm. So they go outside and start walking, in which he proceeds to gradually get faster and faster towards the nearest toy store, laughing maniacally while in full sprint. They enter and now he's saying, "I'm feeling pretty great, guys." Right in the middle of a toy store, and that's pretty much it. He eventually did find out it was a fake and now he's pretty pissed at me. Not my fault, I wanted him to have healthy joints. I was working at a preschool and a little girl, about 4 years old, hurt her finger. She came to me asking for a band-aid, and I explained that, because she wasn't bleeding, there was no need for one. But it hurts. So I soaked a paper towel in tap water, and wrapped it around her finger. She asked, "What's this?" I told her, "It's a placebo, it'll make your finger feel better." She got quiet for a second, and stared at her finger, and then looked up at me and said, "It's working." "Yes, it is." I heard a story once about patients being given a placebo for morphine and felt a reduction in pain. The patients were then secretly given a second drug that blocks the effectiveness of actual morphine. The patients reported their morphine had worn off. Wish I could dig up that link. This would never work on me. If you give me fake morphine, I'm going to rip your arms off. People with the enhance your balance bracelets. Sound mixing. Typically, if the request actually isn't possible for technical reasons, like they are already maximumed out or something. Musician, can I get a little more? Soundman, sure. Pretends to move a dial, how's that? Musician, that's good. Seen it with my own two eyes. I was 21 and had some younger friends who wanted me to buy them alcohol. They were almost 21, but just not quite. I went out and bought them non-alcoholic beer just to duck with them. They all got super drunk. I call bullshit. Anyone who is almost 21 would know which beers are alcoholic or not. Also, if a friend of mine brought me beer and I didn't recognize it, I would read the can/bottle/box, finding out the type and alcohol percentage. Once in college, I noticed leaves on a tree looked like a cartoon drawing of marijuana, so I picked a few of them, put them in a Ziploc, and told one of my friends on my floor that I'd bought weed. He didn't have any rolling papers, so he used printer paper and rolled a joint. He smoked it, and within 5 minutes, was so convinced he was high that he declared, "Oh shit, I have the munchies." Not gonna lie, that's how I thought weed worked when I was 14. Sometimes I need to get injections deep in my joints. It's a really, really long needle, over 6 inches, and it scares the shit out of me every time. I make my doctor shoot me up with lidocaine first and shoot this really, really cold compressed air on the area, so it's all numb. Of course, nothing will stop me from feeling the needle digging around in my hip socket, where I should only ever feeling anything if my leg has been blown off. But something about all the surface numbing makes me feel better about watching him guide the needle on the ultrasound. To be honest, I have no clue if those airborne capsules or emergency C packets are placebos, but if they are, they are the best damn placebos ever. When I start to feel sick, I drink one and the next day I feel like a million bucks. And they taste so good. I used to pretend I was drinking potions, like I was some sort of wizard. Alcohol. If you've ever been to college, you know how much girls like to exaggerate their intoxication. One good example of this was when I was at a frat party. We put this weird Mexican cheap Sprite into the punch bowl, which made it taste like there was alcohol in it. We told everyone that it was spiked. Because it was fruity and pink, all the girls immediately started downing it and stumbling around like idiots. When I was in college, my girlfriends and I always had flasks of our own booze. The girls were probably getting wasted in the bathroom, where you didn't see them, as well. A buddy smoked a joint on his own and had hallucinations. We sold him oregano. You've been visited by Salad Doggo. You will be blessed with good luck for 24 hours, but only if you comment. I'll protect you from vegans, doggo. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe for more daily videos.